Today we're going to do a drawing of an animal eye. This is to help you practice using a range of different tones to get a rounded, solid 3D effect. When you're doing any drawing, it's really important that you're looking very, very closely at the image. That will help you get accurate outlines and shapes. So the first thing I'm doing is just getting a very rough shape here around the eye. Once I've got that very basic outline in, I'm then going to start to work in tone. I'm pressing really hard with the pencil to get a range of darker tones, and these are the ones that I'm going to start with because I can see them most clearly. When I want to achieve lighter tones, I just ease upon the pressure. And hopefully you can see that you can get from dark to light smoothly. And that's when we're blending these together so your tones are not in blocks. All the time I'm looking at the image which is in front of me. So observational drawing is really important. And the more you do this, the better you get at it. It's just like any skill. Looking at fine detail, so here you can see the eyelid underneath the eye kind of forms a white stripe, so we don't want to forget that. We'll keep that in. If you go too dark, it's not a problem. You could just use a rubber and lighten up any tones. Now I'm just going to start to put some contour lines in around the eye. So contour lines are where we move the pencil to flow in the direction that the fur would grow. Choosing a direction to shade is really important because if you're working kind of just side from side to side or up and down, it makes your drawing look really, really flat. So it's important that you work along the shapes that you're observing. So I'm using my pencil and to make these kind of flicks. So we call this mark making, and you can use your pencil or pastels or pencil crayons to create different marks. Different marks will give you different textures, and the more of these that you can practice, the better you can describe the object which you're drawing. So a range of marks will just help you communicate something very realistically. So what I'm doing now is just kind of looking carefully at the drawing and seeing where those different dark to light sections go, because I've not added them all in. And I'm kind of fine-tuning the drawing now, making sure it's as accurate as I can get it. So I'm spending probably as much time looking at my drawing as I am the picture that I'm working from. And you can see I've still got quite a bit of work to do, but hopefully I've done enough now for you to get on and have a go at your own drawing.